Good morning, friends. I am going to begin a bookshelf tour today, and I think I'm going to do it piecemeal. Much like Written in Blood has done piecemeal covers of all of his collections, I find those fantastic short snippets instead of a long, sprawling, epic bookshelf tour. I think that model suits me best, and I'm going to start with one of the most eclectic piles of... It's really arranged by size. You'll see. It's arranged by size. It has a mixed match of horror, old and new, mostly old, but it's some of the books that have fed my writer's prowess, and also just as a reader, things that I've coveted, collected, the things that I found in used bookstore shelves as a kid that drew me into writing, be it the cover, the title, the subject matter, things like that. And you'll recognize some titles for sure, and just get to know what it is that sparks me as a reader and so many other of my reader friends who have gone to used bookstores, thrift stores, or grew up going into these old little paperback stores, or just can't help but go for the older version of a book when there's reprints of many of these. And there's one that's falling apart that I really ought to replace, but I just don't have the heart because there's nothing quite like a battered old copy of Hell House. So, as noted, the beginning of a bookshelf tour, I thought I'd start with a real mix match and partially some of the stars of my books. So this is, like I said, a mix match. The Little Giant Encyclopedia of Palmistry, which I picked up as a teenager. And I'm just going to be piling these up randomly. Shock 3 by Richard Matheson, a collection that I picked up actually recently. And I am looking forward to reading all of these short stories. And I love this green edge. That's such a cool color. Hans Holzer is The Lively Ghost of Ireland. Someday I'll have a full Hans Holzer collection, and those of you in the know may enjoy his daughter's show that has recently begun. Faust by Robert Nye. A weird find, Penguin, and it's not too young. It's probably in the 60s or 70s, but my God, what a wild ride. Highly recommended for those of outsider fringe horror and just really surreal stuff. The Harvard Brief Dictionary of Music, and that is exactly how it sounds. That is a brief dictionary of music with scribbles all over it. I picked that up at the same place that I picked up this, which is weird that they still live together on a shelf. Lord Byron's Selected Poems. This was a gift from my sister, probably for my 30th birthday. Now this one here has been there and back again. Hunt the Witch Down, 12 Real Life Stories of Witches and Witchcraft by Margaret Ronan. It's a little short collection of real life witches, not unlike a collection of short ghost stories. This book spoke to me like no other, and you'll see in here it says, "Hi, my name, Lydia," and it says hi backwards for some reason. I was a fun kid. This book found its way into the seniors room where they have a large bookshelf in the Royal Canadian Legion where I live after my mom had given it away. And a few years later, I found it in there and reclaimed it because, I mean, how can you dispute that it is anyone else's copy of Hunt the Witch Down? Hi, my name is Lydia. A Bible. Because that's scary. Clive Barker, Cabal. This is a French version that my husband and I found here at Black Squirrel Books. And someday I'll learn enough French to be able to read it. So we're going to back it up here. We've got Hell House, Richard Matheson, and it's falling apart. This hurt my heart. It broke not long after he passed away. So yeah, a very tattered, well-read, overread, much often referred to and photographed copy of Hell House. Psycho by Robert Bloch. This is a very old edition, 35 cents it says. That's what I'd love to pay for books. Lithoed in Canada. So really a lovely, lovely copy of, in my mind, Canadiana. Ira Levin, The Stepford Wives. I've read this particular copy and I want to read it again just because it's a great study in character creation. I really, really love this. And I love that cover. It makes it more gothic than it is often believed to be. Fortune telling for fun and popularity. And this goes well with The Little Giant Book of Palmistry. My mother had a very large hard copy book that was passed down from my grandmother of that particular book. Dark Gods by T.D. Klein, best-selling author of The Ceremonies and not much else. Much revered horror author, though, and I love this cover. I don't know if that's visible. Maybe I'll have to do a little zoom in on that. The Satanic Bible by my pal Anton LaVey. And this is a lovely cover. I love the cover more than anything with these dueling snakes. They won't even eat their own tails. Animal Farm, George Orwell. Very slim read. If you have overlooked Animal Farm, just pick it up, man. Like, seriously. It's so little. It's so wonderful. The Song of Roland. This was recommended to me by Stephen King and many other horror authors. This is Child Roland from The Dark Tower Came. You may recognize that sort of speech from the Drawing of the Three. And this is like The Gunslinger. Song of Roland, yeah. Some really complex stuff that I'll have to reread because I read it when I was very young and it went over my head. Amityville Horror, A True Story by Jay Anson. The face that launched a thousand ships, so to speak. Now major American International Picture. I love the back with these flies. This is just a gorgeous, gorgeous cover for a paperback. And People Live Still in Cashtown Corners, Tony Burgess. This is probably one of the last of a dying breed. We got some cheesing here. Picked up here in Ottawa at a CanCon festival. Yeah, Tony. Lovely man. Lovely book. And the other Tony Burgess, you know, the lesser known Tony Burgess, Clockwork Orange. Yeah, this is not the first one I had read. The first one I read had a big yellow cover, very interesting looking book made after the film. But this is a little older one from the Norton Library. Yeah, really brilliant novel, a savage satire and a very different look to these droogs. So there you have it. This is the beginning of what I hope to be a fantastic library tour for you. So I hope you enjoyed that little mini intro to the tour. The others aren't going to be so vertical. I've got more horizontal shelves, proof in the pudding here, but I will probably just be doing a shelf at a time because that is a lot easier for me to handle. I just have to figure out what to do with my hands, right? But yeah, hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching. If you own any of these books or think I ought to get freshies, then let me know in the comments and have an ooky, spooky day.